let's go ahead and I'm curious if anybody has anything right now that they'd like to share. Kind of piggybacking off of last week when we were talking about the four faces of Yeshua and the Merkabah.
But what I was talking about was you and I, when we first engaged with regards to the Merkabah, we were talking about the place of what it is and what it represented, particularly as it applied towards the way that some New Agers see that. And that was the difference between body, soul, and life. And you were asking if there was something to do with the actual word itself that brought that up. And I did discover that if you, you know, through looking at the Hebrew letters themselves, that we could pull out from this place where you could see both body, soul, and light within the root Hebrew words. Now, just so that you know that this is not something that's wrong to do, as a matter of fact, one of the beautiful things about the Hebrew language is that you're able to look at it from other perspectives. As a matter of fact, it's meant to be seen from multiple perspectives.
Yeah.
So you can, in that case, then you can take a Hebrew word and change the letters itself and see if it produces another word. And if it does, then you can see if there's a correlation between the two different words. And you talk about opening up some portals and some dimensions of understanding. It's tremendous because you see how things begin to work together. Mm-hmm. And you know, the fact that we are one in Him, you know, and I like the difference between Echad and Yachad. Echad means that we are one and we operate together as one in Him. Yachad means that we work together and we honor the individual perspectives of all. And so Rakab is kind of like that. Rakab is the root word for Merkabah. And it's Resh, Kaf, and Beit. Resh speaks of the spirit, because Resh can spell the Hebrew word Ruach. And Ruach HaKodesh is the Holy Ghost. Mm-hmm. And so you can pull out the spirit side of that through the Hebrew word Ruach. The Hebrew word Beit, or excuse me, the living letter Beit, would actually have to deal with another aspect of the body. Because see, one of the basic understandings of the Hebrew perspective is that we have been made as vessels, our bodies, our physical bodies. And that's what it's talking about in this case, the physical body itself. The Father had made us as vessels. And in that place, then the vessels are filled with the fullness of the Father, His Spirit. That's why when Adam was first formed, he was just a shell until the Lord breathed into his nostrils and he became a living soul. And so that life that came directly from the Father, and Adam's first breath, of course, was in, because it was breathing in that place of the Father. So there's your Ruach. But that's also the bait as well, because it talks about the filling of the Father inside of us. The kaf, so you got resh, kaf, and bait in the Hebrew word rakav. The kaf actually spells, or is the living letter that begins the Hebrew word kakav. And kakav is the Hebrew word for star. And so it begins to kind of open up a little bit different of a perspective when we look at it from the place of the star, because a star is an emanation of the light. Okay. So in other words, the place where it's like in the earth, we are like the Father's stars here in the earth. We are, you know, His word is a light unto our feet, and a lamp unto our feet, and a light unto our paths. Not only that, but the fact that the Father's light is in us. And there's an expression of his light that is in each and every one of us. And remember that Abraham was told that your descendants will be as great as the stars in the heaven and the sands on the sea. So it's this is directly out of scripture that this is being pulled. And so it's an expression, but it's an individual expression of who we are in Him.
Yeah.
And I bring that up for a purpose, because I want you to realize that there's a place where each one of us shines. There's a place where the Father has put in each one of us a treasure that is ready to be opened up and to be shown into the earth. And that we together, as we come together in Him, we form a part of that light and the expression of the Father.